Now, looking for a good investment these days seems harder than ever. You've heard real estate's a good place to put your money, but how do you really know you're making a good investment? Darryl Baskin from Baskin Real Estate's here this morning to give us some tips. Darryl,
Casey,
thanks for being on Great Day Green Country again. Now, you want to be a real estate investor, right? Tell me some investor mistakes.
This is really fun to talk about because it is painful too, because these are things that I've learned myself. So no one's immune from these types of mistakes.
Uh-huh.
Some of the first things, it's glamorous to say, oh, I'm a real estate investor. And our egos get in the way because everybody's fascinated by real estate investors. But let me tell you something. It is a lot of hard work. And if you're a good real estate investor, you've rolled your sleeves up many times and probably unclogged toilets. you've made small electrical repairs. And this is real down and dirty kind of work.
Mm-hmm.
But if you are doing it properly, real estate can be one of the best investments you can make because you can leverage it. Think about it. You can go out and buy a $100,000 piece of real estate with 20% down, 10% down. If you're living in it, it can be much less. But as an investor, you can put 20, 25% down. Now, you can't do that with stocks.
Right.
So real estate still is one of the greatest investments there are. But here's some pitfalls. First of all, watch your ego. Make sure that this isn't about you and telling all your friends what a great real estate investor you are. A very novice mistake. The second is make sure you keep that property rented because it's your product. It's like sitting on the shelf. And
right.
Every month you let go by, you are losing money that you'll never recover. You can't even sell that at a discount because the time is gone. Time is serious
mm-hmm.
money in real estate. Then renting to a bad tenant can be more expensive than letting it sit empty.
Hmm.
And this is just a nuance of the business that you have to learn. Who is good? Make sure you do your background checks. Don't find yourself renting to a bad tenant because that $500,000, whatever it is per month, can cost you a lot more in damage and repairs and the legal fees to get them out if they're bad.
Now, if you're flipping houses, so to speak, how much time from the time that you get it and you're mowing the grass, you're doing the painting, you're doing the upkeep, you've fixed the fireplace, all that stuff that you need to get done, how much time on average are you going to expect to flip that house and be able to invest in something else?
You really need to plan on about 3 months to do the repairs and the maintenance and changes to it. And in a market like this, depending on how it's priced, you need to be very comfortable with the amount of time that it may take to sell it because
mm-hmm.
you could be looking at a 3 to 6 month selling period, which is why so many people aren't choosing to flip properties right now. They're buying them at a good price, fixing them up enough to rent them, and then they're going to wait for the market to return to sell them. So you could be looking at, it's a combination of buy and hold
right.
and then sell at a later
date. But this is a buying time. This is a buying market.
This is a great time to buy. Interest rates are very low.
Right.
Banks are ready to unload properties. Many sellers are saying, wait a minute, if I lose 20% on this house now, which 20% may be a little bit of an exaggeration in Tulsa's market, but they say if I lose whatever amount of money here, I'm going to gain that when I buy a bigger house, which is what they want for their family. So as an investor or as a buyer or seller yourself, you can look at it. It's all relative. You can look at making that transition. It's not about dollar for dollar. It's about dollar traded on a house versus where you're headed.
Cool. And I'm not looking to buy right now, but I was on your website and saw some amazing, amazing houses. That one that's over 17,000 square feet.
Right.
I actually did the mortgage calculator on your website on that. I can't afford
it per month.
Well, no.
That's okay. We're in the same boat.
You can reach Darryl Baskin at darrylbaskin.com. It's a great website. Or just give him a call. He'll talk your ear off, right?
Yeah.
All about real estate. 918-258-2600. Thanks, Darryl.
Thank you, Casey.
David Edens
yes.
is the owner, been around for a long time,
yes.
so thanks for taking some time today.
Hey, you betcha. It's great for you guys to come by. We appreciate it.
Bye, Harold.
Thanks.